for who has had a share of its interesting bouts. One with Andrew Galata, maybe the most known to bet. And there is Volov, another Russian hopeful coming in here, also very big with the crowd in Australia. Nigel?
He's big in more ways than one, Dave. 7'2", almost 260 pounds. It's very rare for a man this big to be a really good fighter, but he's undefeated so far. A lot of knockouts. Maybe he'll be the first one that'll actually prove that a real big man can be the heavyweight champion.
Okay, good point. Not many have proven themselves. There's Volov, 23, Nelson, 26 years old. 7'2" for Volov, quite a lot higher and bigger than height than Nelson. 316 versus 268. Two very heavy guys in there. And Volov with the reach of 3 inches. Let's see how it comes into play. Well, we're ready now for the ringside introductions. Let's get them from Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening, and welcome to the Trump's Taj Mahal of Atlantic City, New Jersey. Tonight, Top Rank Incorporated, along with Guild Promotions in association with your undisputed, undefeated King of Beers, Budweiser, present an HBO After Dark boxing doubleheader sanctioned by the New Jersey State Athletic Control Board, Boxing Commissioner Larry Hazard Sr., Chairman Jerry Gormley, Board Members Gary Shaw and Stephen Katz, Deputy Commissioner John Greco. Physicians in attendance at ringside are Dr. Dominic Coletta Jr., Dr. Charles Wilson, Dr. Eric Wormser, and Dr. Mark Brennan. The timekeepers working on an alternating basis will be Roosevelt Gilbert and Arthur Spell, and your undercard judges at ringside scoring on a 10-point must system also working on an alternating basis three at a time will be Pierre Benoist, Calvin Claxton, Melvin Lathan, and Larry Laxton. Let's get things started, ladies and gentlemen, with a four-round bout. This is in the heavyweight division. When the bell rings, the man in charge of the action for this four-round heavyweight contest will be Lindsey Page. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing red trimmed with black and weighing in at 268 pounds. His professional record is 6-3, four of his six victories by KO. Ladies and gentlemen, from Paterson, New Jersey, here is Terrell, the Baby Bull Nelson. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing solid black and weighing in at 316 pounds. He's undefeated with a record of 7-0, 6 KOs. Ladies and gentlemen, he comes to us from Russia. Here is the Russian giant, Nikolai Valui.
All right, you already have to explain the rules of New Jersey State Athletic Control Board. I want a good clean fight. I want you to touch gloves, go back to your corner until I tell you to come out. Touch gloves.
And there are the introductions, and you see the extreme difference in height between the Baby Bull Nelson and Nikolai Valui. 7-0, 6 knockouts, average length of fight, a little more than 2 rounds, and Nigel Nelson is looking up at a lot of real estate.
And the torso tucking down low makes him even shorter.
Well, that might be the good move against this big fighter here. He'll try to smother him. Baby Bull, he'll try to be right in front of Valua. Valua will be able to reach back and fire uppercuts in round one. Nelson trying to pressure, walks into an uppercut. That will be something he'll be vulnerable to, but he's trying to smother.
Nelson certainly isn't intimidated. He's taken the fight right to Luev. And so far, he's walked through a lot of uppercuts.
Oh, the stereotype that you brought up in our open about how good are these tall fighters. Very few have proven themselves, and so Nelson will come in with that outlook. Try to come in and soften the body, score down there, and just maybe stay on the chest of Nikolai Valui.
Pretty good left hook there by Nelson.
Valui coming off 2 1-round knockouts over Darren Fern and Patrick Slade. That's right hand attempted by Nelson. Come up a little bit short. Good left hook by Nelson. Nothing on it as far as Valui is concerned, but Nelson getting shots in.
Yeah, he's working hard. He's hustling. And as I said, he doesn't seem intimidated by this giant in front of him. It's a big target.
Let's see how the stamina plays out after the first round, should we get that far. Below with the jab, good right hand by Nelson. It may not have phased below, but it was a clean shot.
Well, it gives him something to think about. You know, he can't get his own shots off if there's a glove in his face.
Abrasion underneath the left eye of Nelson as he tries to pressure below. Uppercut by Valoa, right hand by Valoa, driving Nelson back for a moment. He continues to come forward. Latter stages of round one. And Nelson has employed the style he should be employing here against the tall, very tall opponents.
He's managed to get inside of Valoa's reach and land some punches. He hasn't had a lot on them, but he's scoring some points.
But when he stands up like that, when he gets a little bit tired, Nelson became a big target. And those uppercuts by Valoa are big. And down is Nelson.
Good right hand, straight on the jaw.
As Valoa was moving back. And Nelson will make it to the end of round one. Maryland.
Put it down. Take a deep breath.
What happened?
Corner on the back of the head.
Yeah?
Corner on the back of the head.
Yeah, the key.
It's not.
Give me some water.
Pete, you can't stand up
the
punch, son.
Nelson had it going earlier. He'll get inside and fire the hook. As he was down low against the bigger man, that was a good shot. But at the end of the round, he doesn't cover up all the way. Watch Valoa, looking for his opening. Almost an afterthought. He punched down. He got his target.
Yeah, the thing was, Dave, he had him on the end of the punch because he had a little bit of distance between him and Nelson so he could get some leverage on the knockdown punch.
Caught him in the temple. So, round two is underway. Nikolai Valoa. Getting the knockdown in round one. He is in the black trunks and he is almost out of your screen. That's a good way to identify him. 7 foot plus. Uppercut by Valoa. Jab didn't have much on it. Valoa looks a little bit slow, Nigel.
Yeah, well, he's got a lot of body to move around, and very seldom a man that size is a ballet dancer. You notice this round, Dave Nelson is not coming in, is not getting underneath the punches. I think the knockdown made him think twice about charging in.
He's got some healthy respect now for Valoa.
There's another right hand.
And Nelson in deep trouble. Good right hand by Valoa. He may try to finish it here. Opens up. Good combination. Uppercut. Nelson back against the ropes. Not firing back. Now he fires back a bit. That may have saved the referee's intervention. Jim Page looking very closely. Good left hook there by Nelson. And he weathers that storm. But he is cut badly around the left eye. And they will take a look at that left eye of Nelson. Terrell Nelson talked about the abrasion in the last round, and that opened up into a full-fledged cut, and that is in a bad spot. Looks like it's right over the eye.
I wouldn't be at all surprised.
Well, a spattering of booze, but what else could the doctors do? That's right over the eye, and it bled right into the eye.
It looks like the kind of cut that would bother him throughout the fight. It's in a dangerous area. The blood would have dripped right into the eye. I think the fans, they were enjoying it because Nelson was trying to fight back. But a cut like that, he's not going to last another couple of rounds.
Well, Nelson gets it two ways, Nigel, because it looked like he was on the verge of being stopped there. So he gets a bit of an excuse to talk about later, as we have been known to hear from fighters. So they'll get out of this in the second round. And here's Valoa. Now he has his distance. Without Nelson right in front of him, it's a different story. He can wind up. It's a good right hand going and really pours his punches through here.
Nelson's blocking some of them with his arm, but that was one right hand back, but it wasn't enough to hold off Balu.
A big man with an uppercut from out there is going to have an impact, and Balu certainly did. Jabbing, good left hook, now against a smaller fighter, just asserting himself at this point. The legs are tighter, he is winding up, and he knows it now. He has the feeling he can put this man out. Nelson is not right in his face. So there is distance for Balu, and he uses every bit of it. And Nelson changed his style after the knockdown, and it came back to cost him in round two.
Yes, as long as he was crowding Balu, he was had a chance, but once he got the knockdown in the first round, he was a little more cautious in the second, which meant there was more distance. So the big Russian got all the leverage behind those right hands, and three or four good ones crashed home, and that was it.
So Nikolai Volov ending it in round two, and that's been the average of his fights. He's had one four-round decision and has gone three one time, but otherwise a string of one and two round KOs and TKOs. And this being the cut, but he was also overpowering his opponent. So, let's get the official time of this stoppage from Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, acting on the advice of physicians at ringside, referee Lindsey Page calls a halt to the bout. The official time, 1 minute, 26 seconds of round number 2. The winner by TKO victory, his record now 8-0, 7 KOs, the Russian giant Nikolai Volov.
So Nikolai Volov becoming 8-0, 7 knockouts, and will present himself as a formidable offensive force. We'll have to see, Nigel, what happens when he gets extended, but nobody's been able to do that yet.
Yes, I think we're not really going to find out about him until he starts fighting a little bit of better fighters. See how well he carries that weight over the 6, 8, and 10 round distance. When your average is 2 rounds, you know, that's a lot different than going the distance. Traditionally, the very large fighters have had trouble with stamina over the long distance.
Well, he didn't need any help getting over the ropes either. he didn't go under like everybody else does. He just hopped over. Well, now all he has to do is do the...